have an elite level soccer player, his reflexes are at the best they can possibly be. His stimulus response pathway is second to none. This is peak human physical conditions. You see here, Hugh, we have a classic example of a stimulus response pathway.
What is a stimulus response pathway?
Well, Hugh, a stimulus response pathway is a series of actions that are undertaken in response to external stimuli. A receptor will detect an external stimulus and will send a message via the sensory neurons to the central nervous system, which will then send a message through the motor neurons to an effector, which will perform an action. In the case of Owen here, the receptor was his eye, the external stimulus was the soccer ball, the effector was his leg, and the action was him kicking the ball.
Wow, that's really interesting.
Indeed it is. Now let's look at some detailed diagrams of the stimulus response pathway.
Right, here we have a diagram of the stimulus response pathway. We can see the receptor, the stimulus, the effector, the response, and the neural pathway. To ensure that the effector works correctly, it relies on the circulatory, digestive, and respiratory systems. Our muscles require the circulatory system, as muscles demand huge amounts of oxygen to work, to which the circulatory system provides. This is because blood carries oxygen to the muscles. Blood also carries nutrients to our muscles, which is necessary for them to repair and rebuild. Our muscles also require the digestive system because the digestive system extracts nutrients from food that we eat, and our muscles require nutrients to function properly. The respiratory system is also necessary, as without it we would not be able to get oxygen, which is vital to our muscles. Now, let's move on to a deadly disease called ALS that would likely have made Owen unable to kick that ball. ALS is a motor neuron disease that causes motor neurons to break down and die. Once our motor neurons break down and die, they become less effective in communicating to muscles, which leads to ALS patients not being able to voluntarily move their muscles. If Owen was able to move his muscles, then he would have been able to kick the soccer ball. Despite ALS being around for many years, there is no way to cure the disease, and only 10% of the patients will survive 10 years after being diagnosed. However, thanks to medical advances, we can provide treatment for ALS. One form of treatment is drug Rizul. Rizul is a drug that is used to regulate the high amounts of glutamate found in ALS sufferers. An excess of glutamate means that the nerve cells in the brain are overexcited, which leads to them dying. This can be prevented by using Relzine, but keep in mind that Relzine is not a cure to ALS, but only a treatment. Relzine can prolong survival for a short amount of time, but it's extremely ineffective in minimizing symptoms of ALS. All of its information together shows us how deadly ALS is due to the fact that there is no effective cure or treatment, and the effects that it has on the human body and would have on Owen's body.
Fell in love with
ALS patient. Turn the camera on, see a nexus of glutamate